Tatay Goni, with the Prince of Rao, Thank you, Father, for the sacrifices and the many, many prayers. Now, as we celebrate Jesus Christ's attendance today, my true love, allow me to acknowledge the most loving, caring, and amazing wife, Rina. I found my true love very early in my life, as Rina and I were elementary school classmates in the big city. And I'm proud and happy to say that every woman in her has been the cutest ever since. We have children, Amina, Miguel, Sabrina, and Luigi, who are joining us virtually by Zoom, are a testament of our true love. My other personal guests are my high school classmates from the same city, police general, state of the which is the outgoing chief of police of Palawan, and Mr. Oscar, my brother. The search is bad. My brother knows a lot that you are a bad influence during your high school days. That's why he made sure before I report to us from that you are going to be transferred, hopefully, in a better place. And those are my special guests, again, from the Puerto, going on to the order of the day, let me start by saying Maraming salamat po sa ating Commander-in-Chief President Rodrigo Roman Duterte for entrusting Western Command to my care. I also wish to thank Senator Bongbo, Honorable King Donizana, and the AAP Board of Generals, led by our Chief of Staff and Andres Rubino, for favorably endorsing me to this post. Rest assured, sir, that on behalf of the men and women of Western Command, we will continue looking after national interests of our country, which has so delicately situated in the so-called last frontier of the Philippines. God Almighty, thank you for the gift of life and responsibilities. I mentioned earlier the phrase delicately situated. I believe this is a phrase which will guide me see through the mission of Westcom, serving only the best interests of the armed forces of the Philippines. I have worked closely with the men and women of the ground service, the Air Force, Army, and Navy, and I was at General Headquarters as your J-4. Our wonderful work relationship was nothing short of amazing, having accomplished much during the critical periods of the AAP modernization program and, more recently, our battle against COVID-19. It is the same management framework that I intend to harness the full potential of our armed forces as we see through the completion of the good works which the outgoing commander, Vice Admiral Ricarte, recently gave to us. By doing so, we fulfill our mandate of protecting our people and securing the national interests of our country. Ceremonies and a single character and commitment to soldiers were manifested in numerous occasions as home was home. While we at the building fleet focus on our force surviving goals, we have also been monitoring the confluence of events in the West Indies in the AOR. Through technology played a key role in the play a critical role in the transmission response of combat bombing and the swarming of vessels which began in the Navy, the dumping of sewage and other hazardous fuels of the AAG, and the harassment of enemy flag vessels in the area of Ayumi. The most essential factor which resolved all this was the unfaltering leadership of combat bombing and maintaining a physical presence despite harassment and threats, as well as the timely elevation of reports to the National Task Force on the West Indies. All these provided the peace of mind that we enjoy today. And as far as ISIS was concerned, we learned that strategy is in interest, in support to the principles of enemy and attack. So the neutralization of the colony centers through top leaders and group points which came away from the mass surrender and the global support from CPG personalities. And meanwhile, and among many, CPG prioritized the interests of those severely affected by super typhoon death, as he unselfishly utilized all the general plans given to him by higher importance for the victims of super typhoon death, citing they need all the humanitarian assistance more than those who are rescued. Vice President Rizal, as I am to know, ang gusto pagdala at pagdala sa inyong mga nagpumisahan ng programa at kawain dito sa Westcom. Let us ensure that all of this will never go missing. And with the indulgence of our guest honor and our predecessor, I will serve the details of my command guidance to them in Westcom on another occasion. However, allow me to share the general foundations of my guidance to Westcom. One, we will all align the senior leaders upward on my personal doctrine of mission first, men always. Second, all our actions, programs, and activities here at Westcom shall center on promoting the interests of the armed forces of the Philippines, and lastly, a culture of competence and ship-shaped lifestyle will be the order of the day at all times. So, Murin, I am here, Admiral Alberto, Carlos, signing in as the commander of Western Command, and for Chief of Staff, men and women of Team Westcom, ladies and gentlemen, as we say in the Navy, I have